Prepare to be amazed as we uncover incredible stories hidden within vintage photos, revealing a whole new perspective on historical moments. These images offer a captivating glimpse into a world filled with wonder and adventure, challenging our expectations and leaving us in awe. Betty Brosmer, a 1950s icon, was a highly sought-after supermodel with a perfect hourglass figure. She won over 50 beauty contests before the age of 20 and became the highest-paid model of that era, inspiring generations of women to embrace their curves and feel confident in their own skin. In the late 1970s, supermodel Jerry Hall was a fashion icon, rocking the yellow jumpsuit like no other, exuding confidence and grace on the runway. Even now, decades later, her influence can still be seen in modern fashion trends. Annette Bening rose to fame in the mid-70s with her captivating performances on stage and screen, quickly becoming one of the most sought-after actresses of the decade. Linda Vaughn, known as Miss Hurst Golden Shifter in the 1970s, was a prominent figure in motorsports, representing the Hurst brand and bringing glamour to the sport. The original Addams Family set from the classic 1960s television series is a timeless piece of Americana, located in Hollywood, California, designed to look like an old-fashioned Gothic mansion with spooky decorations that made viewers feel as if they were with the family. The mockumentary This Is Spinal Tap, released in 1984, is widely credited with creating the genre of rockumentaries and has been praised for its hilarious take on the music industry. Chris Farley, at the age of 16, already showed his comedic timing and physicality, entertaining friends and family with his infectious energy and enthusiasm. Stevie Nicks, the iconic singer-songwriter of Fleetwood Mac fame, stepped off stage after her sold-out show in Amsterdam in 1977, marking the start of her solo career and the beginning of her journey as one of the greatest female rock stars of all time. During the late 1960s, a young Randy Poffo was already making a name for himself in the world of wrestling with his athleticism, charisma, and showmanship. He was developing his signature style, which would later become his trademark. In this classic photo, we see five 80s icons, Muhammad Ali, Hulk Hogan, Cyndi Lauper, Liberace, and Wendy Richter, together at WrestleMania 1, representing the larger-than-life personalities of the 1980s. Ellie Mae and Granny are the coolest riders around, sharing countless memories on their beloved bike for over 30 years, creating an unbreakable bond that will last forever. The 1984 tour of David Lee Roth and Eddie Van Halen was a legendary rock and roll event that will never be forgotten. The tour, which ran from January to May 1984, saw the two hard-rocking icons performing together for the first time in 5 years, much to the delight of their fans around the world. From the opening notes of Jump, one of the band's most iconic songs, to the closing chords of Panama, audiences were treated to an unforgettable show filled with high-energy performances and classic hits. On top of that, Eddie Van Halen's incredible guitar solos throughout the night left everyone mesmerized as they experienced the power and magic of this dynamic duo. It was truly a magical moment in music history. The Dream Date Portrait Pillow, ad from 1974, featuring a pillow with an old-fashioned portrait of a man, has been etched in many people's memories ever since. This classic piece of advertising was created by artist Bob Peak, best known for his work designing movie posters for films like Apocalypse Now and Superman, the movie. In 1968, Elvis and Priscilla Presley welcomed their daughter Lisa Marie into the world, solidifying Elvis's status as one of the most beloved entertainers of all time. In 1959, Elvis Presley was having breakfast with his father and grandmother in their home in Memphis, sharing stories about life growing up in Tupelo, Mississippi. In 1974, Elvis Presley was on his way to a sold-out concert, with fans lining up for a glimpse of their idol as he passed by. His presence was electrifying, and everyone knew this performance would be something special. Farrah Fawcett's trailer on the set of Charlie's Angels was adorned with photos of her cherished memories, serving as a place of solace between takes. Goldie Hawn's role as the free-spirited, independent hairdresser Jill in the 1975 film Shampoo inspired women with her strength and courage. The flight attendant uniforms from the late 1960s were truly iconic, with bright colors, bold patterns, and daring designs that made a lasting impression on passengers. These outfits embodied the spirit of the era and have been featured in films and television shows, cementing their place as some of the most recognizable flight attendant uniforms ever designed. The iconic Dolly Parton stands in a sun-drenched field, wearing her signature rhinestone-studded outfit with a straw hat atop her head, just after releasing her smash hit single, 9 to 5, in 1980. The 1986 release of the collaborative album, Blah Blah Blah, by Iggy Pop and David Bowie forever changed the world of music, showcasing the talents of two influential figures in rock history with a mix of punk rock energy and experimental sounds that made it an instant classic. In 1969, Janis Joplin performed at London's Royal Albert Hall, captivating the audience with her powerful blues rock sound and leaving a lasting impression on the international music scene. John Travolta embodied coolness on the set of Grease in 1977, becoming an instant movie star with his iconic leather jacket, slicked back hair, and effortless charm. His magnetic performance captivated audiences worldwide, making the film one of the highest-grossing movies of all time and cementing him as a Hollywood icon. Kris Kristofferson, a true icon in 1972, shocked the world with a fresh-faced new look when he shaved off his iconic beard, capturing a time of transition in his career. Led by legendary guitarist Jimmy Page, The iconic band created an unforgettable sound that has influenced generations of musicians since its release. Mariska Veres, the lead singer of the band Shocking Blue, was a Dutch rock icon in the 1970s, known for her powerful voice and energetic stage presence. Marty, Doc, and Einstein from Back to the Future Part 2, 1989, are a timeless trio that has been beloved by generations of fans. Today marks the 60th anniversary of Michael Jackson's birth, and it is a day to celebrate one of the world's most iconic entertainers. In 1972, on this very day, he was waiting backstage in London for his show to begin. He had already achieved global fame with the Jackson 5, but now he was about to embark on a solo career that would make him an international superstar. That night's performance was electrifying and showcased his incredible talent as a singer, dancer, and performer. It was the start of something special. From then on, wherever he went, audiences were captivated by his unique style and energy. To this day, Michael Jackson remains one of the most influential figures in music history and continues to inspire fans around the globe. The cast and crew of Monty Python and the Holy Grail were ready to film iconic scenes in British comedy history, despite the dreary weather. During the filming of True Grit in 1969, John Wayne and his son Ethan wore matching eye patches, creating an unforgettable sight as they recreated the classic Western film. In the iconic photo of Jim Morrison taken in Paris, 1971, an unexpected surprise can be found, a young boy peeking out from behind the window as the legendary singer stands alone on a balcony overlooking the city. The 1950s was a time of nostalgia and style, with rolled-up jeans and saddle shoes with white socks representing freedom and rebellion against the status quo, as well as comfort and stability for carefree youthfulness. In 1974, Rush had a legendary performance in Ohio, with fans screaming and singing along to every song as they jammed on stage. With Alex Lifeson's electric guitar riffs, Geddy Lee's powerful vocals, and Neil Peart's intense drumming, the trio created an unforgettable experience for everyone who was there. In 1984, Sammy Hagar released I Can't Drive 55, and was seen in the music video rocking out in a classic red sports car with a wild look of determination on his face, capturing the rebellious spirit of the time. Sharon Stone rose to fame in the 1980s and became an iconic Hollywood actress, starring in some of the most legendary films of all time. In 1967, Steve McQueen showed off his 1957 Jaguar XKSS to Sonny Bono, Cher, and Twiggy in London, sharing stories about his time racing on the track in California.